Were there a couple of moments where you were, and I know it's, there's got to be millions of them over the course of just an evolving career, an evolving decade. Mm-hmm. Were there a couple of moments where you were just like, dang, this is it. Like, I'm really onto something.
Yes. Yeah, there were some indicators early on. The first band that I started managing was this band called Sweet Crude. Yeah, and they're a wonderful band from here in New Orleans. They sing in half English, half Louisiana French. And I saw them playing at Gasa Gasa one night in late 2013. And they blew me away, and I'm like, I've got to manage this band.
Yeah.
And I didn't have any bands I managed. I was just super passionate about their music, and I loved it. And it took about 4 months, 5 months of meeting with them and convincing them that they had something special.
Yeah.
And that they probably needed an extra hand, and that I was the guy for the job. It you know, and finally they eventually brought me on, and. They, you know, a lot of the wins that you accumulate as an entrepreneur and as a manager are because your clients are so talented.
Yeah.
You know, they're great. So all I do is put in that extra hustle and I try and get more eyeballs and ears on my artists. Because at the end of the day, they sell it, you know. But there was just a lot of victories that we started getting early on. Great Jazz Fest slot, the Abita stage at French Quarter Fest, and then on the cover of Offbeat, and then a small record deal. And it's just, and then you'd tour out of town and you'd see people that, you know, the crowds would get bigger. It's just like, okay, I'm not making that much money from this, but like, this feels good.
Yeah.
And as they started to develop and get really noticed in town, then they'd be like, who's their manager? And so I started to get, and so I built up my roster from there. And so at that point, I had a good stable of artists to where I was making enough money and could quit the bartending, but I was still tour managing the Soul Rebels as, like, that was still my primary source of income.
You were fully embedded in music at that time.
And yeah, so there was a summer where I had been out on the road a bunch and also managing my bands as well as going out on the road with the Soul Rebels. And 3 months go by and I got a call from the Lowe's Hotel, which is where I was bartending and worked there for like 6 or 7 years. And they're like, do you want us to keep you on the schedule? You know, you haven't done a shift in 3 months. I'm like, holy shit, yeah. I've been able to go 3 months, and I looked at like the several months ahead, and I'm like, no. And like realizing that like that's when I was making the leap, like I'd fully gotten my life to where I was just doing all music,
wow.
business. And that was a great feeling.